I was gonna read you some of Tennyson's stuff tonight, but why should I? You never read any of mine. You scratch my back and I'll scratch yours, innit? The Pest pulled up, propped his push bike at a pillar box, pulled his peen, paused at a post and pissed. Pissing the proper place pronounced a perturbed pedestrian. And presently, this particular part of the planet was plunged into a panorama of public pressure and pleasure through pain. The pandemonium prompted the police who patrolled the precincts in panda cars to pull up and peruse the problem while pickpockets pickpockets in pairs. Arrest the Pest who so pointedly pissed in that public place, pleaded the peeved people, practically palpitating. The powerful police picked up the Pest, pronounced him a puff, a pansy, a punk rocker, a pinko, a poodle poker. They picked him up, pummeled his pelvis, punctured his pipes, played ping pong with his pubic parts, and packed him in a place of penal putrefaction. The period in prison proved pitiless. The pendulous pressure of a painless personality purge prompted the Pest to ponder upon progressive politics and a workable prognosis. He put pen to paper and provocatively and persuasively propagated his personal political premise. Pity. A police provocateur put poison pellets in the Pest porridge. The police provocateur was promoted, and the Pest was presented with the Pulitzer Peace Prize, posthumously. Sad one, that is. True story, true story. 145 bloody six, I'll have a fag in a bit.